The cosmetic industry is growing rapidly, with interest now to the younger generations. But physicians say that they're concerned on how some are cutting costs and are now ending up with bad results.
So sometimes cost cutting is dangerous. You have to kind of wonder, well, what are they doing in terms of quality, in terms of safety, to deliver some of those lower costs? So really looking into the background of your cosmetic injector and your cosmetic clinic and seeing if there's value there that you want to place an investment in. It's pretty important. The industry isn't as regulated as we would like it to be. Probably will become more regulated in years to come as the growth continues.
One procedure physicians are seeing being done incorrectly is PRP, platelet-rich plasma. Or some people are even purchasing improper products, which can cause even more damage to the skin.
PRP has been in the sports world for quite some time, and it's been used for tendonitis and sports injuries. And the theories behind it is, if you think of when you sprain your ankle and your ankle becomes swollen, in that fluid, which is platelet-rich plasma, there are growth factors and healing factors. And the idea is it will introduce those factors into an area to create collagen and regenerate the tissues and heal the tissues. Now, getting plasma from an individual does involve drawing their blood, and it has to be in a specialized tube. Everybody is familiar with blood drawing because we all go to the lab and we get our blood drawn for cholesterol and blood sugar and those kinds of investigations. But in particular, the tubes that are used for investigations such as, you know, blood sugar and cholesterol, that tube isn't appropriate for platelet-rich plasma in the setting of a cosmetic use. Those tubes are meant to be brought over to a machine for testing. So the tubes that we use to draw your blood are specifically indicated that we can take that plasma and then re-inject it into you. There's no added chemicals or thinners.
Physicians say you also need to ensure the patient is healthy and doesn't have any underlying issues in their medical history.
Because if you're unwell and we're taking your plasma may not be the quality that's going to give you the results that you'd like. So knowing the medical background of the person is important as well. We wouldn't sort of recommend that procedure if you're quite ill at the time, because the quality of your plasma may not be there, and it's a cosmetic procedure, so wait, get better, and then decide to do something along the lines of PRP.
But the good news, when the procedure is done correctly, it does create a collagen stimulation environment in the dermis, and that helps to improve skin appearance like acne scars and can even stimulate hair growth.
A healthier skin with a healthier glow and a reduction in lines. PRP is often used for hair as well. You can kind of think of it as aerating the lawn. We introduce micro perforations in the scalp and then place PRP, platelet-rich plasma, in all of those perforations. And the idea is similar to the way you aerate your lawn and fertilize. When you do that in the scalp, it can stimulate hair growth. So people who are just starting to experience some hair loss may get some really nice results of PRP in the scalp. So mainly we use it in the scalp for hair and in the facial microneedling procedure for skin tightening. Those are the main indications that we've found helpful.
So just remember, you get what you pay for. And when dealing with medical procedures, ensure you're attending with a professional licensed doctor to avoid any potentially harmful side effects or poor results. For Halton News, I'm Kristen Demeny.